Hey everyone!
I'm going to do a review today of the Radio Flight Easy Fold Wagon. You can buy this for about $200 from Toy World in Australia. So I'm just going to that's the full extension there of the handle. It's actually quite a good length. I'm pretty tall and I have no worries pulling that one around. It's the right height. Doesn't feel like I have to sort of bend down. It has a little magnetic, I'll just show you. It's a little magnetic clip here. It's very small, but it does hold your pull handle up off the ground. Good shake's gonna dislodge it. You could whack a kid in the face. So I'm not the biggest fan of that. But it is a way to store your pull handle on this wagon. So I'll just show you the inside first, guys. There are two little lap belts in here for your kids. They extend quite a bit, so you can probably get a couple of 4-year-olds in here together, or up to maybe 1 6- or 7-year-old in here in this wagon. It folds up really easy using this little pull handle, so one hand fold, pretty much. Flaw here though is that they don't have a strap to hold it closed for you, so you have to sort of use the pull handle to keep it closed when you're loading and unloading it. Just pop it back out. It is padded here, and it is padded a little bit on the bottom. Actually, it's padded quite a nice amount on the bottom, and I think that's the difference between maybe buying this and buying sort of your Kmart or your BCF Anaconda beach wagons. It has four little telescoping canopy holes. They're really easy to get up. My daughter hasn't worked them out yet, but she will because she loves pressing buttons and they just go straight back down. So if a child was doing that, they might get a finger clipped in there, and I imagine that would hurt quite a bit, actually. But that's not a favourite for me, those canopies. They have a really tiny little, like, plastic clip, like a snap, like on your cloth nappies, and they clip in. If you have a beautiful day like today where there is not much breeze, this is a great wagon. Great wagon for a picnic. Great wagon to put your child in for a little rest out of the sun. It doesn't have a great weight rating, so you're probably not going to be able to take 2 kids and all your stuff with you. This skirt around the edge, I don't know if I like that. Could be a mud flap, I'm not sure. It never seems to sit nicely. Same with the pop-up canopy. It definitely does not sit super well, but I mean, it's gonna shade your kid great. Okay, so we have cup holders, and they've got a little mesh bottom here. So if there's condensation, it's just going to drip right out. I think that's actually a really good feature for a cup holder. On the back, you have got a little storage pocket. Just fit a few things in there. Just going to grab a water bottle. Here you guys. This is probably actually as big a water bottle as you're going to fit in your cup holders. Now the wheels,
they go okay. This is not a beach wagon, this is definitely a wagon for people at a park.
But I'll give it a little twirl around for you guys so you can have an idea of using it without any kids in it. I have used it with my daughter and my son in there. He is about 32 kilos and she is about 12 kilos. And that's probably the end of the weight rating for this thing. I think it takes about 50 kilos all up. It's really nice to pull, actually. Uphill and downhill and on different terrain.
I think this is so light.
It makes it feel really easy. Like I said, a heavy breeze is going to probably put this off, but on a day like today where you just need sun protection, that's pretty good. It doesn't have a brake, so you're going to have to park it somewhere flat or it might just roll away on you. Alrighty, I'm going to show you holding up this canopy. So it's sort of a pop-up, it just sort of folds back in on itself like this, and this storage goes back here. I think it'll just go down. Watch your fingers. Strap that's holding it together, locking it together, so that's the most secure way to sort of cart it. It's so light, you know, after lifting my W2 in and out of my boot, I used this for touch footy last night and I was just like, oh, it's so nice and light, so easy to get in and out of the car. I do love that about it. It doesn't take up any room in your car either. I just lie it flat and then you can put stuff all around it or on top of it. Our wonderful wagon definitely takes up a lot of real estate in my boot. Anyway, that's my review, guys. Definitely a few improvements to be made on this wagon. If you're listening, Radio Flyer, you really need to have a locking mechanism to hold it together when it's folded, and a better canopy. I think they do actually have better models of a stroller wagon style that you can buy from Radio Flyer, actually, but this is the one that I could buy easily here in Australia, and like I said, for only around about $200, it's definitely a good stroller wagon option for families that don't want to spend a lot of money on another pram or have barely any boot space, or if you know you need to take this on a bus or a train or a tram, guys. It folds up so neatly and it is really light. It's actually lighter than our beach wagon. So we have a Tawali beach wagon and it's lighter than that. Okay, that's it. That's it for me.